threats sometimes get past antivirus and start running. And when they do, the EDR capabilities in Microsoft Defender for Endpoint surfaces alerts that analysts can investigate and block. However, it'd be great if your security solution blocked and contained these malicious behaviors in real time, right? That's what we thought. So we built EDR in block mode as an extension to our behavioral blocking and containment capabilities in Defender for Endpoint. It shifts EDR detection to EDR blocking on the client, even if Microsoft Defender antivirus is not your primary AV. Think of it as an extra layer of post-breach detection against malicious artifacts or behaviors. It's quick, too, reducing the reaction time to a fraction of a second. EDR in block mode supports both active and passive modes in Microsoft Defender antivirus, with cloud-delivered protection turned on in either case. If you haven't yet enabled EDR in block mode, we strongly recommend that you do. You'll even see a suggestion in Threat and Vulnerability Management to turn it on. Doing that is easy. In Settings, select Advanced Features, and then turn on Enable EDR in Block Mode. Once turned on, when Defender for Endpoint detects suspicious behavior, Microsoft Defender Antivirus blocks and contains the artifact on the client in real time, even if the artifact is already running. In the Microsoft Defender Security Center, you'll then see alerts that show that it blocked the artifact, and the detection source was EDR. This is powerful stuff, and nothing beats a real-world example to prove it. Recently, a nanocore rat attack targeted a customer to steal credentials, spy by using the device's camera, and more. It started with an Excel file that contained a malicious macro. When users enabled the macro, it ran a PowerShell script that downloaded and ran the nanocore payload. The customer's third-party antivirus missed the Excel file, macro, and PowerShell script. Defender for Endpoint did not, however. EDR in block mode stopped the behavior and blocked the Excel file and PowerShell script. We encourage you to turn on EDR in block mode to enable behavioral blocking and containment at every stage, from pre-breach to post-breach. To learn more about it, see our documentation on Microsoft Docs.